I remember when I was little, I did not always want to go to church. So my mother, while she was getting ready to go to church, she spoke aloud a phrase that even today makes me reflect. "Salvation is individual," she said. In fact, although we can help someone find the way to salvation, we cannot save them. Therefore, all should cultivate their own spiritual life. The chapter 14 of Ezekiel makes such a clear truth. In this section, God speaks of the judgments that would come upon his disobedient people. But there were among some Jews, the pride of being of the family of great men of faith, Abraham, Noah, Daniel, Job, individuals who were synonymous of heroes. However, God warns that being of the family of such men did not influence the divine tribunal at all. In verse 20, we read, "Even though Noah, Daniel, and Job were in it, as I live, says the Lord God, they would deliver neither son nor daughter, they would deliver only themselves by their righteousness." It is interesting that the Bible emphasizes that being the son of great men of God, or even being of the family of heroes of the faith, does not guarantee salvation. This is because kingship alone does not convey spiritual values. Each one must cultivate for himself the good virtues. And today, I wonder how sad it must be a family half saved. Father be separate from son, or brothers separate from sisters, because religion was not cultivated in a similar way by all. Not everyone took it seriously. And then, in the face of the final judgment, the parental union can be separated because there is no spiritual union. So think, how is your family today? Have you been worried about everyone's spiritual life? Have you asked how they are cultivating their faith? Do not plan on spending eternity without a member of your household.